guys, it's me again, Jozelle Tech, your PWD Philippines Insider. I've been working by online for the past 9 years, and the most frequent question I get is, paano ka kumikita ng pera kahit nasa bahay ka lang? So this is my workstation, and let me tell you how exactly I do a living at the comfort of my home. Watching, I am able. This is where we talk about our dreams, challenges, adventures, success, and some tips and tricks on how to enjoy life even with a disability. So if you're a PWD or someone who is interested to know how PWDs can overcome limitations and live life to the fullest, then be sure to subscribe to my channel to keep posted. Thank you. Mwah. Now let's roll. I am a graphic designer by profession, but a traveler and a blogger by passion. As I said on my previous video, I dreamed of being a pilot, but the job is not suitable for me. So I chose a more practical course in college. I took information technology, as the most practical employment for me is to professionally use a computer. A month after I graduated from college, I started to look for a job online. Wala pa akong idea noon, hindi ko pa alam kung saan ako magsisimula o paano ako mag-i-apply. Basta ang goal ko, makahanap ng trabaho. Until I discovered about Craigslist and OLX. Before, hindi pa combined yung sulit.ph at saka yung OLX.com. Kasi ngayon, more on products na sila. But before, they are like the Philippine version of Craigslist. May iba't ibang advertisements for products, dating, and jobs, at iba-iba pa. So from there, nag-check ako ng mga hiring. From the start, medyo nahirapan ako kasi bagong graduate, wala pa akong experience. Kaya mahirap makapasok. Pero sinaga ko lang. Kumukuha ako ng mga freelance work, yung mga madali ang trabaho, like poster designs, banners, research, o kaya yung mga website edits. Yung mga natutunan ko from college. Usually, mabilis ang trabaho lang yon. At saka, extra income lang talaga. Ang gamit ko pa noon, desktop. Yung gamit kong computer nung high school ako hanggang college. Hindi pa ako agad nag-invest for a computer. Kasi una, okay pa naman yung desktop ko. Kasunod, wala pa naman kasi ako stable job. But luckily, after 2 months, I was hired by an American company based in Miami. It's a digital marketing company. Ang in-applyan ko talagang role doon, graphic designer. But then, he offered to train me as an SEO specialist. SEO means search engine optimization. It's a siyang branch ng online marketing that would affect the visibility of a website sa mga search engines like Google and Yahoo. The interview and the hiring process are all done by online, sa Skype at saka sa email. Kabado pa ako nung una kasi wala akong idea eh. Pero sobrang sayo ko nung nakapasok ako. Cause finally, I have a stable and a full-time job habang nasa bahay lang ako. Back then, my initial salary was 10,000 pesos. Year 2009, okay na yon. Hindi ka na ma-hassle sa pamasahe at sa food. Although, syempre, mas mataas yung sa kuryente mo. At stepping stones ko lang yon, kaya sobrang happy na ako doon. I think once or twice ako sumusweldo noon every month. Gamit ko noon PayPal. From my client's US bank to PayPal. And then PayPal to my local bank. Naging maganda experience ko with that company because I learned so much. Especially with online marketing. I also experienced training, coaching, recruitment, and even people management. So I'm very grateful to Ducks Marketing because it opened so much opportunities for me. I quit the job because my shift is a graveyard from 9 p.m. until 6 a.m. in the morning because sinasabayan ko yung oras sa Miami, which is 12 hours behind. 8 hours work with 1 hour break. So tulog na lahat ako, nagtatrabaho pa. And hindi ako masyado nakakapagpahinga kasi usually umaalis kami ng hapon o kaya maingay na. So medyo kinukulang ako ng pahinga. So with graveyard shift, my health was at risk. So I needed to quit even though gustong-gusto ko yung company, especially the environment and my client, Sergio. But he understood. And up to this day, we still keep in touch. Importante yan ha, even sa online work, always have a good relationship with your former client as much as you can. Nung nag-quit ako doon, my salary was around 20,000 pesos already after 2 years of working with them. May mga salary increases ako kapag maganda yung performances ko o kaya pag may additional workload. So after a month I resigned, I jumped to being a marketing assistant to a real estate company. With that company, my salary was $600 USD. So before, that was about 25,000 to 30,000 pesos a month. Depende sa palitan. I stayed there for a year. Tinapos ko lang yung contract ko. Then I moved to different roles like virtual assistant, web designer, or even project manager. Madami rin akong napasukang company at marami rin akong nasubukan trabaho all throughout the 9 years experience. Minsan nga pinagsasabay ko pa eh, especially if late lang yung work o kaya magkaiba yung schedule. May one full-time job ako and then I have a part-time job or freelance work. Pwede naman yon as long as you can deliver with quality. For me, sa online job, iba rin yung marami kang skills na alam. Usually kasi yung mga foreigners, especially the Americans, sila yung tipong nag-hire ng all-in-one. Yung pwede ka sa marketing, pwede ka sa design, pwede ka sa blogging, or yung pwede ka nilang ilipat-lipat ng department. Siyempre, mas makatipid sa kanila yon. Pero hindi ka rin naman lugi, especially kung okay naman yung sweldo mo. Also, with that system, marami ka rin matututunan. So, pwede mong madagdag yung sa resume mo. And sa experience and skills mo. So, mas madali ka mapagkakatiwalaan ng ibang company. Pag mas marami ka rin kasing alam na skills, mas makakapag-negotiate ka ng salary mo. Ika nga, jack of all trades, master of none. I think that perfectly describes me. And kapag mas marami ka namang experience, mas mapagkakatiwalaan ka. Since sa online ka na mag-work, they cannot supervise you. Kahit na may monitoring app pa, it's about trust pa rin. Na magtatrabaho ka at babayaran kanila. Although, I always go back to the one I love the most, which is design. I think I am a graphic designer half of my online career. Even up to now, although I am doing freelance work right now, I really had an amazing experience working via online with different companies abroad, like the US, Canada, Australia, England, Singapore, and a lot more. Fun fact, my favorite client is Australia. Currently, I'm doing freelance work as it gives me more flexible work hours, control over the projects and the clients, and I get to be my own boss. I chose to work home-based because it's practical, less expense with fare and food. Especially with the traffic we have here in the Philippines, ayoko na sumali. And it's more comfortable. Katulad ngayon, ito lang ang workplace ko. In my bedroom, with my dog. At madalas nakapambahay lang ako, unless may video call or interview. Pero minsan, yung top lang yung nakaayos, and then yung bottom, nakapajama or shorts. Cons. Probably, you don't get to socialize with other people like the usual setup in the office. Pero may mga makakausap ka naman, like yung mga co-staff mo, yung clients mo. Usually, kausap mo sila sa chat room or sa Skype. So, dun kayo makakapag-interact. Although, some companies now have meetups and gatherings from time to time. Magkikita-kita kayo in a place or pupunta dito yung client nyo and then magkakaroon kayo ng event. Naka-attend na ako ng ganon siguro twice. Recently, the founder of the company that I'm working for right now went here to the Philippines and we had a meet-up gathering. I actually vlogged about it. I will be posting that soon para rin makita nyo kung saan ako nagtatrabaho ngayon. And maybe you can also apply to them. So far, am I making sense? Please comment below whoever wants to work online or kung sino dito yung mga nagtatrabaho na via online or home-based. It can be boring sometimes, yes, especially if graveyard shift ka. Isipin mo, tulog na yung lahat, ikaw gising-nagising pa. Although, the perks are always the best. Imagine, you can wake up 5 minutes before your shift without even brushing your teeth or combing your hair. Hindi ka naman yun makikita eh. Isn't it the best? Through the years, I get to upgrade my system for my home-based job. Right now, I have 2 laptops with basic marketing and design softwares installed and basic components like mouse, headphones, and camera. Yung dalawa yung laptop ko para I have a backup system na pwede ako magtrabaho kung sakaling magka-problema yung main laptop na ginagamit ko. Then, my internet provider right now is Sky Broadband, yung 16 Mbps, nakabundle siya sa cable namin with 36 channels. I think it's amounting to $1,999 a month. I also have an internet data sa phone ko and a tattoo stick para may backup internet ako just in case na maputol yung broadband. As I always say, backup plan and alternatives are a way to success and less stress. As for my salary right now, I don't really share it to anyone but my client. But for you guys, sige, it's around $7 to $15 per hour, depende sa project at sa client. Alam nyo guys, sa online, we can have multiple income streams. So ako, may freelance work ako as a designer, but I'm also into dropshipping and merch. Those are another sources of income via online. Sa online kasi marami ka naman talagang pwedeng pagkakitaan eh. Although sa una mahirap kasi nag-uumpisa ka pa lang, kailangan mong pag-aralan, trial and error. Pero ang pinaka-key dyan, maraming pasensya at tiyaga. Kailangan tiyagain mo, aralin mo, and the fruit of your hard work will come next. As for me, even though I have 9 years experience online, I believe that I am a work in progress. I still need many things to learn. With vlogging and freelancing, I get to meet different people all over the world. And I believe that everyone I meet knows something I don't. And from them, I learn more. I learn from their experiences, my own experiences. I learn from different people I work with and I'm working for. My advice is, in everything you do, just keep on trying and learning. Make it work until it does work. And while doing freelance work, I also do blog on the side. Like this one, I create content for my fellow PWDs and their guardians to share insightful ways on how we can make our life as a PWD enabled. By the way guys, I will have another video about working online, some tips and Q&A. So kung may mga questions kayo or concerns about online job, working online or home-based, comment lang kayo sa baba and I will try to answer all of those questions as much as I can sa upcoming video ko. So I think that's it for today. I hope you like it. If you do, please thumbs up. Comment below if you have any questions and subscribe if you aren't already. Thank you! And my question is, are you able?